everyone, I'm Emily, and today we are learning the science behind milk fireworks. For this one, you're going to need a plate, some food coloring, some milk, the fattier the better, some dish soap, and a Q-tip or something similar to a Q-tip. Before we dive into our experiment, we need to learn two big things. One, the science of surface tension, and two, the science behind soap. So one, surface tension. What is surface tension? Well, surface tension is that film on top of liquid that is created by the attraction between molecules at the surface. You've probably seen surface tension if you've ever seen water building up on top of a penny or an insect walking on top of a pond, right? Well, how does that happen? Here's a basic diagram of our plate. And if we filled it with water, those blue dots here, those would be the water molecules. And the cool thing about water molecules is they all want to be friends with each other. They're all slightly attracted to each other, kind of like they all want to hold hands with each other. So if we look at that same diagram, the water molecules in the center, they want to hold hands with molecules above them and below them and to their side and to their diagonal. They have water molecules all around them. But look at the water molecules right at the surface. They only have molecules to their side and right below them. They don't have any above them. That's just the air. So what happens is that they hold on even more tightly to the ones right beside them and the ones below them. They bunch up closely together and they hold on really tightly to each other. That is what's creating our film. That's what's creating surface tension. And we can do a mini experiment right here to demonstrate the science of surface tension. So I have a glass of water right here, and I also have a little spring from the center of a pen. Now, this spring is made up of some type of metal that would easily sink to the bottom of a glass of water because this is heavier than water, right? But watch when I do this. If I gently lay it on the surface, da-da-da-da, it floats on the surface because of surface tension. Now watch when I do this. Boink! It goes right down to the bottom because, yes, it is heavier than water. So now that we understand surface tension, let's understand the science behind soap. Soap is made up of these little itty-bitty chains of hydrogen and carbon and oxygen atoms. And on one end of the chain is the sign that loves fat and oil and dirt. On the other end of the chain, it loves water. So on this end, it's known as lipophilic, fat loving. It loves fats and oils and dirts. This side is hydrophilic. It loves water, hydrophilic, water loving, right? So imagine what happens, you know, when you wash your hands, when you're lathering your hands with soap, what's going on there? Well, one end of those chains is grabbing on and bonding with all the fats and oils on your hands. And then when you rinse your hands under water, the other end of those chains is bonding with the water. And as it falls off your hands and goes down the sink, it takes all of those oils and dirts and fats along with it. And that's why it's important to wash your hands with soap and not just water, because water doesn't bond or mix with oil. We can see that right here. I have water and olive oil in this glass, and you can see that they don't mix. They don't want to bond. They don't want to be friends. So if you're washing your hands with just water, it's not doing much. So now that we know that, let's get to milk fireworks. We're using milk today. All that stuff we talked about with surface tension is relevant for milk because milk is made up of mostly of water. It also has fats and proteins and minerals in it, but mostly water. So let's go ahead and pour our milk into our plates, just like this, very carefully here. Okay, perfect. Once we have that, we can add just a few drops of food coloring right to the center. Now, I want you to take your Q-tip and just dip your Q-tip in the center. Ta-da! Nothing happens, right? Nothing happens. Now, take your soap, your surfactant, and put it on the top of your Q-tip. Now, we talked about those little chains of atoms, how they have a fat-loving end and a water-loving end. Because it has these properties, It's a surfactant, which means that it reduces the surface tension on a liquid. So soap reduces the surface tension on a liquid. And let's see that in action right now. Okay, one, two, three. Milk fireworks. So there's a couple of things that are happening here. We talked about those little chains in soap where one end bonds with fat and one end bonds with water. Well, those actions are happening all throughout our milk because milk contains both fat and water, right? That's all that activity that we're seeing with our food coloring. The food coloring is just on the surface to show where all the activity is moving. A second thing is happening here. We're breaking that surface tension right in the center of our plate. But around the circumference of our plate, those bonds between the molecules of water are still intact. They're still trying to hold on to each other. They're still trying to hold each other's hands, and they're grabbing at each other to the left and to the right and to the center. And so that's bringing all of that activity out radially to the edges of the plate. And that is the science behind milk fireworks.